invite a couple people up to share the stage with me, my co-writer Amy Velk, director of photography Jeremy Sonier, and the cast, Kim Taylor, Ned Oldham, Jack Carneal, Derek Campbell, Hannah Gross. Please come on up.
Start with the first question. I don't know if you would, you and Amy want to talk about your collaboration on the script and the just origins of the story.
Sure. The very seed was actually set in Ocean City. I had a scenario for a film that would involve this Illinois student visa there. But, you know, we got her to Baltimore and then really couldn't, at least I got her to Baltimore and then really couldn't figure out what I wanted to do with her next. And Amy and I took a look at it, and then the rest came together. How did it come together?
Well, Matt had this idea about like a really tense, taut sexual triangle between these two girls in the pool house, kind of, which we abandoned because. And then also maybe they were Eastern European, which I don't know anything about, but I know a little bit about Northern Ireland. So, and also about families and people talking to each other and, you know, falling apart. Yeah, that's how it started.
And Amy and I have both been married and divorced, and that seemed like something that we could explore on screen. Our goal being to try to do it in a really balanced way, kind of giving every one of the characters involved in this separation, as it occurs, their own voice.
What was the collaboration like with, Ned and Kim want to talk to, involved with the music and songs and writing of them?
Sure. Yeah, I'll say we cast them fairly early while we were still writing, so their songs really informed the script and the characters. Amy and Kim had gone to school together, so Amy introduced me to Kim's music. We got Kim and Ned together in Charlottesville, Virginia, where Ned lives, and kind of the rest is history.
What do you want me to say?
What were the conversations like when you were writing the songs and for the character?
I don't know if we had conversations about the songs per se, but
I should say there were songs you'd already written.
There were songs that I'd already written, and you know, Days came out of sort of a bad time in my life. It was, writing Days was sort of the way I pulled myself out of, you know, my misery, I guess. And music in general is how I pull myself out of my misery. And so, yeah, it was just a pretty natural, you know. And American Child was as well. It was a song I had written prior, so.
So, yeah, we used those as references and wrote them into the script, as well as Ned's music.
Yes, one kind of nice apocryphal detail of the songs is the song that Jack and I were playing in the basement when Abby and Taryn were looking at us, was a collaboration that wasn't really a collaboration, but it was from recycled lyrics from Matt's dad, which he wrote. I said, should we ask him to use them? That's a feeling he won't know that there is. But written decades earlier, and then one that got away, this guitar smashing song, something I've always wanted to do, never been able to afford to. It was actually about the elusiveness of being able to do what you want. It really was, and so that the female, seemingly female object of the song is not really, I definitely wasn't thinking about a woman at the time. And then the other thing about that song is that it's one of those songs you had the lyrics and then just started playing it and it just kind of wrote.
The question's about the cast preparing for their characters.
I've been married for 20 years. And I have a 14-year-old daughter and an 11-year-old son. And that is really an intense kind of, you know, it's an achievement and a trial.
I love my wife.
I actually had many similarities with Abby, such as theater school, and then coming about dealing with parents. My parents aren't divorced, but they are parents. So. And just talking with Matt and Amy before scenes really was how we prepared, how I prepared.
She had a lot of tabbouleh as well.
Spat it out.
Hi. Well, I'm not Irish, so I have to work on the accent.
Northern Irish.
Right. Matt invited us down to Baltimore and had a reading there. I remember Matt saying that casting was a lot about just getting a group of people together that worked and made sense. And certainly I think one of the successes for me was that we do seem like a family.
I'm also a mom. I have a 14-year-old son, so I know what it's like to be a parent. And my parents divorced when I was 18, so it was very interesting for me to get to play the role of the mother, you know, because I could really empathize with Hannah. So yeah.
It was partially funded through Kickstarter. A crucial piece kind of early on, as we were entering production and still finalizing deals with some private equity investors. It's kind of a well-timed campaign brought in about $42,000. Let's see, casting. Well, again, we kind of wrote early on with Kim and Ned in mind. They kind of came to us fairly organically because of Amy's relationship with Kim, and I knew Ned for a while in Baltimore. Lived there for some time, and I knew his music. Incidentally, I met Dara and Hannah at the New York premiere of Putty Hill, and we kept up a correspondence. But as Dara cited, it really all came together this, you know, spring weekend in Baltimore in April, when everyone came down, and we read through the whole script. Jeff, who has the beard, plays one of the members of Kim's band, as well as Nick, were there. Sorry they can't be here with us today. They're both friends and Baltimore musicians, so they were guys that I just wanted to see on the screen, and I liked a lot, but were charismatic.